We have drawing, we have painting, we have mixed media, we have ceramics, and there are a few sculpture pieces.
For over 25 years, Irving ISD has hosted the annual Exhibition of High School Art, a showcase of work created by the district's talented young artists.
A lot of the kids that we have in fine arts, their passion, their reason for being, their reason to going to school is their art.
It's an opportunity for teens who love art to express themselves, and for those with career aspirations to have their very first gallery show and present their AP art portfolios. It's an important tradition that almost halted due to COVID.
So last year, we weren't able to have the show, and it was really, really hard on the seniors. They are used to having a senior portfolio where they're focused their own exhibit in the gallery. So our teachers are so amazing that with the cooperation of the Irving Arts Center, we partnered to have a digital show for our seniors. And they also made sure that the AP portfolios happened. And so we ended with a really positive note.
And 2021 brought more positive news.
I have to say, I was so excited to get the call from Marcy Inman when they said, hey, do you want to do a show? And, you know, I did cartwheels in the office.
The logistics of putting together an art exhibit during a global pandemic are not easy. But the teachers and administrators had already come through a year of challenges.
When this pandemic hit, we were literally pushed into the deep end of the swimming pool, not knowing how to swim.
One of the things that you alluded to earlier that just kind of stops me in my tracks is, in a usual year, in a typical year, your student goes to school and the supplies are there and the things that you need to work with are there, and so they make art. They couldn't do that this year.
Right, and that was one of the first things in the spring that was so difficult because we didn't know how we were gonna do school. We didn't know how we were gonna buy groceries. We didn't know how we were gonna do life. And our teachers were just like, well, if we can't leave our house, how can we get our kids clay? How can we get our kids acrylic paint? They don't have those supplies at home.
The teachers also had to come up with novel ways to teach foundational concepts remotely.
Some of it was thinking very out of the box on how we can teach those same concepts. How can we teach 3D? Maybe it needed to be modeling clay. Maybe we need to do Prisma pencils, colored pencils instead of paint to start with right now. So there was a lot of modification, not lowered expectations, but thinking out of the box of how we can use different materials to teach the same concepts. It's kind of what we had to do to start with, and then as soon as we possibly could, we got the materials that our kids needed in their hands.
And that's when all the adjustments and modifications and learning how to teach art concepts online paid off. The students poured their energies and skills into work that surprised and delighted their teachers.
When we hung the work and the teachers just looked around, I mean, it was almost like a moment of silence. They were like, this is good. This is good work. This might be one of our best shows.
The work reveals the students' talent and mastery of technique, but it also reflects some of what they faced during the last year.
One of the things that we noticed as the year went on was what an emotional struggle it was for the students and how deeply and profoundly it affected the students to be separated from their teachers, from their peers, from their friends. And so one of the things that we did this year was we incorporated social emotional learning components into our high school curriculum to keep that connection really strong.
Teachers encourage their students to infuse those emotions into their art. One of the students expressed her exhaustion with COVID in this piece.
That is actually a slot machine, and pulling the slot was the question and the how unpredictable life is every day with COVID. And you can't really see closely, but there are tears streaming down the face and they connect at the bottom of the chin.
The piece was selected to compete at the state level in VACE, the Visual Art Scholastic event. The quality of the artwork, the challenges faced, and the goals achieved all combined to make the 2021 exhibition exceptional. Lawrence says that she can sum up her feelings about this year's effort in a few words.
There's one word for me. Well, no, there's two, because I never have just one word. The first word is pride. I'm so proud of the kids because they could have checked out and many did, I'm sorry to say. And the second one is, I feel like it's just a victory. It's a victory, I think, for the Irving Arts Center, because they've missed this. It's a victory for our teachers, it's a victory for our students, and it's not a bubbly, oh, this is a great show. It's like, this is a great show. This is maybe the best show because of what had to take place for it to happen.
This is Kathy Whiteman reporting.